Y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Today I'm going to share with you my grocery haul that I got from Whole Foods today. And if you want help on your fibroid healing journey, go down in the description box and check out the Fibroid Detox Workshop on Demand. It can help you on your healing journey. With that, there are some options for ongoing support. So let's get right into the video. So here is what I got for my husband and I. These are pretty much staples that we use all the time. There's a few new things in here, but we always do fresh blueberries. And I am in love with flavor bombs. They're not organic, but the regular tomatoes did not look good. So I got flavor bombs. I just washed them and cut them up and put them in my salad. Next we have blackberries. I don't love blackberries. But what I do is I chop them up really small sometimes, or chop them in half, and then I can tolerate them. It's a texture thing for me, but they're really good for fibroid healing. And triple berry mix. If you haven't gotten on the triple berry mix, especially this one from Wyman's, you need to get on it because it is excellent for your smoothies and for healing. Next is broccoli. Broccoli is a cruciferous vegetable. It helps to metabolize excess estrogen out of the body, so it's excellent to have some broccoli. Black seeded grapes are excellent for detoxification. I love to freeze the grapes and eat them like while I'm watching a movie. That's my popcorn. So there's a tip. Aloe vera juice. I like the whole leaf. If you have constipation issues or your stomach is just a little bit upset, or just you need your gut healed in general, aloe vera juice is excellent to add to your smoothies or just add it to your lemon water and drink it in the morning. And of course, watermelons are not in season, but I eat watermelons all year round if I can find them. So this one is going to be a watermelon smoothie. Next is raisins. I love adding raisins to my salads because it gives me just that little bit of sweet, and it also is a texture thing in my salads. Next is radicchio. Radicchio is excellent for salads. I cut it up really small, but it's a bitter lettuce. So what it does is help with your liver. That's the main benefit of why I eat it. Sushi rolls, nori. I love them because I want to do something other than just salads. So there you have it. I'll give you guys a recipe video with nori sheets. But I love to have fresh seasonings on hand. Frontier's my favorite. I use seasonings for my salads and my salad dressings. Next is baby spinach. My husband loves to put spinach in his smoothies. I like it too, but he is the spinach person. But remember to rotate your greens. So do like spinach and kale or spinach and collards. So here's my second green that I have here that'll last us a few days here. So chopped kale. I think I'm gonna make a kale salad out of that one. Then we have some apples. My husband likes to eat apples. I'm not like really an apple person. I love apples, but I don't just go grab an apple, but that's his thing. Those are gala apples. But the next game-changing thing that you should add to your diet is microgreens. Microgreens are so mineral rich and they are a living food. It takes your healing up a notch when you add microgreens and sprouts to your diet. Next are avocados. I add avocados to my salads. They're a great healthy fat. Also an anti-inflammatory is turmeric and ginger. I love adding these to my juices. And you can add them to your smoothies as well. So if you have pain in your body, or if you get menstrual cramps, or you're feeling bloated, use these anti-inflammatory root vegetables like turmeric and ginger. You can even add garlic. I have some garlic here, but I'll talk about that in a minute. But white onions, add them to your salads. They're excellent for antioxidants. And they also help with your healing, the healing in your body. Lemons, of course, I love for salad dressings, and limes I love for salad dressings, but I like to put them in my water too. Garlic, add that garlic also for its anti-inflammatory properties to move the inflammation out of your body. If you didn't realize this, Fibroids and reproductive issues are an inflammatory condition. So adding things like turmeric, gingeric, garlic, onions, these things are gonna help move the inflammation out of your body. And also my oranges, I forgot to mention those. I love them for my water or just to add to salad dressings or to eat for a snack. These are my menstrual supplies that I will be using this month, NatraCare, because they didn't have what I like at the store, but I do like NatraCare as well. This is the regular brand, the regular size. And also I like to use the panty liners as well. I don't bleed heavy anymore, so wonderful. So the next thing I'm gonna use is another type of onion, which is a green onion. You add those to your salads or your soups or whatever you're making. This next thing is jalapeno. You guys know I like to put the jalapeno in the juice or the smoothies for circulation. Get that circulation going to move that stuff that is in your body out that doesn't belong there. And also the lazy woman's salad mix, which is spring mix, because you don't have to wash it. You just put it in a bowl, or you can chop it so that you can make, you know, put more greens in your bowl. So that's what we have for this week. This will not last us a full week. It'll last us like a day and a half, maybe. And then my bananas. I like to stock up on bananas because I like to let them get really ripe. And once they're really ripe, I peel them and put them in freezer bags and put them in the freezer for my smoothies. So this is my grocery haul. I hope you enjoyed it. Please comment below and let me know what your favorite part was. If there is a particular recipe that you would like me to share with you, please comment that below. If you like this video, like it. Share it with somebody you think it could help. And if no one told you they love you today, Chelsea in North Carolina loves you very much. And I will talk to you all soon. Lots of love.